Microsoft VP, God can use whatever you have to spread the gospel. A Microsoft executive, inspired by her Christian faith to help build a school and rescue center with World Vision for girls escaping female genital mutilation, encouraged Christian women on Monday at a conference to use their passion to serve God. Speaking at World Vision's Women of Vision National Conference, Microsoft Vice President Margot Day told those in the audience that God can take their experiences and their abilities and make a difference in the lives of people around the world and to help spread the gospel. In her personal experience, God was able to use her influence in the business world to make a difference in the drought-ravaged country of Pokot, Kenya. Being in Microsoft, I know lots of people. I know lots of people in business, she said. In partnering with World Vision Kenya, they said, people are sharing the word of what I'm doing, which is sparking interest with people to want to learn more. That interest allowed me to get others involved in God's work in the African country, and also to share her Christian faith with a Philadelphia businessman. The experience began when Day began contemplating her future with Microsoft in the spring of 2009 and seeking God's will. She realized, I had stepped away from my childlike faith. Day said she felt the desire to do something for God but did not know what she could do. Although she worked for a top technology company, Day said she is not a millionaire. However, God used the biblical story in Matthew 14 of Jesus feeding a multitude with nothing more than 5 loaves and 2 fishes to inspire her to act. She said that God's voice told her, 5 loaves and 2 fishes, what you have is enough. That thought alone led her to travel to Kenya in September 2009 and witness the toll drought and famine were having on the village of Pokot. She also learned how village girls were escaping their families to avoid female genital mutilation. The World Health Organization described FGM as the partial of total removal of the external female genitalia. The procedure often causes severe bleeding and urination problems as well as potential childbirth complications. FGM is internationally recognized as a violation of the human rights of girls and women around the world. Kenyan girls who have undergone FGM at the age of 6, 7, or 8 are later married off by their parents at age 12 or 13 in order to get a dowry of between 50 to 60 heads of cattle, they described. In Pokot, a local mission partnered with the local World Vision Water Project to house 35 girls escaping FGM. However, they said there was no secondary school for the girls to attend and little job opportunities for the girls once they reached adolescence. The experience fueled her to help build a school. After returning to the United States, they told World Vision officials, guys, I'm not going to let this one go. 30 days later, World Vision Kenya drew up plans for a 366,000 school facility.
I would like to go to the part of the story where Day said she felt the desire to do something for God but did not know what she could do. Although she worked for a top technology company, Day said she is not a millionaire. However, God used the biblical story in Matthew 14 of Jesus feeding a multitude with nothing more than 5 loaves and 2 fishes to inspire her to act. She said, God's voice told her, 5 loaves and 2 fishes, what you have is enough. My guess is that there are quite a few Christians out there that feel like they are not in the position or in the best position to serve or help others. But you know, this is where faith comes in. You know, God told me this at a time when I was struggling financially, but I was spiritually strong. He said that I had everything I need to succeed. And I made that my screen capture for a long time to remind myself of this. When you think about this, if you have the Holy Spirit and a desire to do God's will, you really do have or will have access to via God everything you need to succeed if you just keep the faith. Right or wrong? Now, did you all know about this FGM, which is the partial or total removal of the external female genitalia, which often causes severe bleeding and urination problems, as well as potential childbirth complications? The article said that FGM is internationally recognized as a violation of the human rights of girls and women around the world. Thank God for Day and her willingness to step out on faith to do something about this atrocity being imposed on these young women by their own parents. Let's read a little bit more of this article to see what Day has been able to achieve.
Day's personal donation of $150,000 plus the donation of her Microsoft colleagues funded the start of the project. A local woman of Vision Chapter helped raise the money needed to complete the project. Women of Vision is a voluntary ministry of World Vision that equips women to use their resources to advocate for children around the world. 4 years later, the four-block St. Elizabeth Girls Secondary School houses about 124 girls escaping FGM. The school features dormitories for students and teachers, as well as biology, chemistry, and computer labs. The local World Vision Water Project has also been completed. It provides the school as well as the surrounding community with fresh, clean water. It's causing the transformation in this community, Day noted. She reported that the rate of FGM in Pocock has dropped from almost 100% to 20%. It has also created opportunities for Day to share God and the Great Commission with those in the business world.